light the fire with these chairs.
Be used to being in the hot seat.
8:56, 8:58.
8:58. Who was that?
Line unmuted.
You got the bow hooked up, Mr. Nance, this morning, huh?
Huh?
You got your bow hooked up?
I spent about $800 on a night over there. Mississippi Lake.
Oh.
I ain't put in the water since.
Oh. Well.
But I got it.
It's on record?
Yeah, it's sitting on record.
You've been a long line of folks. I'm passing them, I just ain't hooking on them.
I'm ready to go on the month of 20.
Yes, sir.
Ready to go, sir?
Yes, sir.
Is it? Is it up?
It's up.
Is it too high, the fish?
You know, I hadn't heard anybody's been in the fishing. I don't think folks up in City of Carrick are biting on. They go with it. But I hadn't heard any good reports about fish biting.
Oh, my, well, there, you got to go fishing next week. And I know she don't eat that many fish, I think.
If she say, "Oh, you better go," Mr. Nance.
Aye. Hey, we get, go ahead and get started.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you for today, we thank you for blessing us, taking care of us, we thank you for the opportunity to serve, and we just thank you for how you bless our county, and we pray that you'll be with us through this meeting and business. And we'll be done so in a way that's pleasing to you. We just pray that in all these decisions, that we put you first, and we'll be able to do this, give you this guidance, wisdom, and knowledge. But we pray for this nation, and we pray that you'll continue to instill in our leaders your will and your ways, and all the mercy and grace, and thank you for that. Be with those lowering the capacities that are on the line and serving. We pray that you'll be with our first responders, and military, and their families, Lord, continue to bless them and guide them. Just to guide and direct us through this meeting, and we thank you for all these things, Jesus.
Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Commissioner Miller. Before we get started in our meeting, we always read a protected order that we have. In order to protect the public and the Board of County Commissioners, the conference line has been set up to accommodate community access to the meeting. The conference line number is 1-917-900-1022. Access code is 32347. This is not a toll-free number, and you may be subject to long-distance charges according to your long-distance plan. When the chairman opens the meeting for public comments, please follow instructions. Please dial 5, the moderator will unmute your line when it's your turn to speak. And notify you by announcing the last four digits of your telephone number. Please announce your name and address. You will be allowed to speak for 3 minutes. This meeting will also be livestreamed on the Taylor County Board of County Commissioners Facebook page. You must have a Facebook profile search on the Taylor County Board of County Commissioners, and you can do the meeting at 9 a.m. The Facebook livestream will not be monitored for questions or comments. Please call the conference number if you wish to speak. With that being said, we go to number three, approval of the agenda.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion second, all in favor? The next thing on the agenda is bids and public hearing. Number four, the board to receive sealed bids for, set for this date at 9:05 a.m. or soon after as possible.
If you want to record the bid committee members, it'll be myself, Hank Evans, and then also, it'll be a North Florida Professional Service, which is the design engineer representative, so I'm not sure if it's going to be Eric Gill or Judy Pittman. I've asked one of them. We'll have to review, we'll have to accept these bids and then forward those to DOT for their confirmation.
So we did receive the three on the list there that we received before the deadline. We actually did receive a fourth one yesterday on Monday, after the deadline, so we won't be opening that one.
Is that LAS contracting?
Yes, LAS contracting.
And that's what I literally was sending him I sent him an email this morning questioning, had he, because he told me he had submitted one on Thursday. He said that they've submitted it, and I sent him an email this morning saying I thought you had submitted because I didn't see the list indicated. So it arrived obviously too late.
Right, it arrived Monday, March 15th, at 10:48 a.m. And the deadline was March 12th at 4:00. So the first one we have is
and that was an overnight FedEx.
Mm-hmm.
Because he told me he bid it on Thursday, March 11th at 12:38 in the afternoon.
Yeah. That's what they got on here. It's got a label on it of Friday, March the 12th at 2 p.m. to overnight, so.
Okay.
When was the deadline?
Friday, March 4th. And also, it was not marked that it was a bid either outside, so it had to be open.
Yes, sir.
To be identified as a bid. So the question you have here is Kurtz.
A lump sum amount there, we did one like the second or third page.
$467,073.66. This one's Anderson Columbia. And it's $502,510.50. Anderson Columbia from Lake City, Florida. third one's American. In American Design Engineering. Theirs is $421,000.
Even, you said?
Yep.
$421,000 even?
Yes.
And they're literally from just about the south of Florida as you can get. And that they're the teams. Anyway, we will review the bids to make sure that they meet the specifications. There's a lot of federal things that they have to comply with before they're considered compliant. We'll have DOT participating in that role as well, because as you know, this is a lab project that is federally funded. They will have to give us concurrence with acceptance of the award. And once we get that, we'll bring it back to you guys.
Okay, you did say Hank Evans himself, and who else?
I said a North Florida Professional Services representative. I've asked, the actual engineer was Jimmy Pittman, but the project coordinator is Derek Gill, so I'm not sure who they want to put on it. But it'll be one of those.
Okay.
How far away is the pavement is the sidewalk on?
It's only about 4 or 5 feet. That right of way through there is a 40-foot right of way. So a lot of it, as you know too, there is the old railroad bed that goes through there, and there's a pretty good swale that comes up to where the railroad bed was built, and it's pushed as far as it can go and still try to tie into the existing ground without, matter of fact, there's a couple hundred feet, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, of gravity wall because it's dropping off so bad.
Right along there where they had that wreck where the oak tree is right up next to the road.
Seems like there might be a cross there or something, but it's on the southern part of the,
right,
of the project.
Yeah.
But I mean, it's, you know, it'd be nice, and that's why we always push a lot of times to have a minimum right of way of 60 feet and for your larger roads to get to the 80 feet kind of format, because once you get a 22-foot wide road, it's literally just about impossible to put anything else in there. So anyway, I'll get copies of this stuff from Gary, maybe later today or tomorrow, one or two, and then we'll move forward with it. Right, thank you, guys.
Number 5. The board can receive bids set for this date at 9:10 a.m. as soon as jail control panels. Anybody speak to that?
Okay. The bid committee will be Marty Tompkins, Mark Stevens, and myself.
I have received two bids. Montgomery Technology Systems out of Greenville, Alabama, and Stanley Convergent Security Solutions in Fisher, Indiana. All right, so the first one I have here is Stanley Convergent Security Solutions. Their bid, this is number 2 on the list, Stanley Convergent So the Montgomery Technology was 88,600.
That sounds closer to our budget. So we'll review these to make sure they meet technical specifications and bring a recommendation back to the board.
Okay, you said that was you, Marty Tompkins, and who?
Mark Stevens. Yes, sir.
Long way, yeah. I just wondered, this question, is somebody underbid it, or does somebody just overkill it?
Somebody didn't need to work.
Make it slow down up there, Mr. Jim.
Okay. Is that all you got for that? Consent agenda items? You gonna go with consent agenda items, or their motion to approve or disapprove? You wanna pull something off?
Number 10, I don't think that we need to discuss number 10 at all, for the gas plant road. I mean, I know the, they're in the notes here, they were talking about, you know, maybe some insufficient funds and, you know, potentially discussing, you know, changing the proposal of what was to be done on that road. Because, I mean, apparently we have some insufficient funds to complete the project the way it's drawn out. Is that what I was, did I read that correctly?
Let me see exactly. I think that's always a concern with these projects. I mean, I can ask Kenneth to come back down.
I what I read through there, there was some items that.
Right.
Needed to be done, I just didn't.
So this is a request to advertise the request for proposals. Once we receive the proposals back, then Kenneth and the other staff can review the proposals and may anticipate at that time to reduce the scope of work.
Okay.
All right, so I heard a motion to approve?
Motion to approve.
All in favor? Ready. We go to public request. Am I right with that down, going, that's all the way down to 14? Board to consider approval of amendment 2, cooperative agreement for the Taylor County, Florida, and a broadband by rail project. The cyber as agended by Heather Fuller, the grant administrator for Langston Hughes, Langston Associates.
She is on the line. She should be number 3164.
Number 3164. Ms. Heather Fuller.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Commissioners. Good morning, Mr. Chairman. How are you?
Good.
Great. This is Heather Pullen from Langston Associates, and I'm here today to talk about amendment number 2. I have attended meetings since December of 2020 to inform you guys of the process of how this amendment has evolved in time. We did receive approval from the FRA to send the amendment to the Board of County Commissioners for final approval. Just a reminder, the scope is being adjusted to include the redecking of 3 bridge structures that were not included in the original scope of work, as well as the upgrading of signal controllers at the 3 grade crossing locations. The cooperative agreement is what we're discussing today. It is being amended to amend the performance period that was originally due to end tomorrow, March 17th, 2021. It is now being extended for an end date of June 30th, 2021. And we did not have a grant budget amendment. However, we did amend the current budget to move $25,000 from the contingency line item to project management to cover the cost for grant administration through the end of the extension of the new grant award. Are there any questions from board members regarding the content of amendment number 2?
Okay.
Heather, hey, this is LaWanda. I just wanted to make sure sure that we were all clear that this would not be an additional expense to the board, that the project actually came in a little bit under budget, and that's why we are able to ask for this amendment, is that for the additional scope of work, is that correct?
That is correct. We had several hundred thousand dollars left in the budget of the grant, and so it was in the best interest of the county to move forward with this new scope of work, considering that two of the three locations are located in Taylor County. I think we've provided in the past the exact locations of those on the rail line, and I would be happy to provide those once again. However, I do want to mention a note that this is not, the amendment that is being voted on today is not a paper submission. It is submitted electronically, and we offer limited due to time restraints because the original grant actually expires tomorrow on March 17th. So this will be an electronic submission of the amendment, and LaWanda and I will work with you on that. Are there any questions, from the board regarding LaWanda's comments or my own?
I just want to make it clear to the chairperson that at the conclusion of this meeting, that we will log into the Grant Solution account electronically and accept the award.
Okay. Did you hear that, Helen?
I did, yes. Rowan and I have you all set up in the system, Mr. Chairman, and we're ready to work with you.
Okay.
You're ready.
Very much motion approved.
Second. Motion second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, you got it. Number 15.
Six.
The board to consider approval amendment to construction engineering and inspection services agreement with the Langston Associates as intended by the county administrator.
So this is related to the previous item, and this is to allow Langston Associates to continue the grant administration services for the duration of this project. We anticipate that the fiscal impact will be around $18,750, and maybe a little more, a little less. That is grant funded and it's within the project dollars.
Okay. Motion approved. Second.
Motion second. All in favor?
Aye.
You got it.
Thank you. Thank you, Heather.
Thank you all. Have a wonderful day. And I'll talk to you soon, Chairman Dent.
Okay, we go to 16, county staff item. Number 16, the board to consider approval of the State Housing Initiative Partnership, SHIP program, the Local Housing Assistance Plan at LHAP certification. The request to adopt the authorizing resolution for the state fiscal year 2021, 2022, 2023, 2023 to 2024, as agenda by Melanie Cox.
So I'll be speaking for Ms. Cox. The county is required to update the LHAP at least once every 3 years, mm-hmm. or if there are any proposed changes to the program to be eligible to receive the SHIP funding. So even though we did not receive SHIP funding this year because of state budget shortfalls, we are still required to update the LHAP. And it has a resolution that must be adopted.
Okay, do we need to read this resolution?
You see it on the, it's on the file.
No.
Okay. One of the things that there needs to be a correction on it, where it says directing the mayor. We don't have a mayor. We've got a chairperson.
Right.
We need a motion to read that.
Motion.
Okay.
Title.
All in favor? Title only?
Yes.
Title only, Mr. B.
The resolution of the Board of County Commissioners of Taylor County, Florida, approving the Local Housing Assistance Plan as required by the State Housing Initiative Partnership Program Act.
subsections 420.907 to 420.9079 Florida statute and rule chapter 6737 of the Florida Administrative Code, authorizing and directing the, I'm going to put chairperson to execute any necessary documents and certification needed by the state, authorizing the submission of the local housing assistance plan and review and approval by the Florida Housing Finance Corporation and provide an effective date.
Now, public hearing, we should allow the public to participate if there's any.
I don't believe this is a.
Not an ordinance, it's a resolution.
Not a public hearing.
It's a resolution.
Okay, a resolution, okay. You need to order, you need to pass it.
Need to approve the plan and then approve the.
Do we have a motion? A second?
Second.
Motion is second, all in favor?
Aye.
All right. That's one, do we need another one?
Yes.
All right, we need another.
Second.
Motion is second, all in favor?
Aye.
All right. You got that one taken care of. We go to general business now. Vote to discuss the naming of the sport complex as adjourned by Commissioner Moody.
I think it would be a real good thing to do to name the sport complex, that's Mr. Manlatter. And he touched so many young people in the sports field and supported all, you know, baseball, football, everything over the years. And he was just, he meant a lot of young children coming along in this county.
Years ago, not just now, but years ago. Like in the 70s, I remember his name.
I second that. I mean, I know growing up, he was the face of the sports complex as far as one of the recreational sports. If it was anything from us, you going out and hitting balls at night and turning the lights on and letting, and coming out there at 9, 10 o'clock at night and turning them off. Going back home, you know, I remember you organizing teams, you know, a lot of times there was never no kid left behind, you know, anybody coming in, he was always bring them on, welcome them, no cut off point, you know. Mm-hmm. Just, I second.
I'm sorry, my favor, I think it's a good thing, as long as, I guess, folks have spoken with this family, they'll be in support of that. Structure that, have a recognition time to celebrate all those things that you've come.
Motion is second, all in favor?
Are you doing a motion in second tonight, or you want to wait until his family's here?
Well, I think it probably, the vote is probably everyone agreeing. Everyone agreeing, and then later on, we want to set up more of a formal.
Right.
That's right. Set up for the family to have the family come in. Maybe, I don't know, maybe do it at next month, you know, first meeting of next month, or the second, whatever.
Well, if I could make a suggestion, if y'all want a new sign for the sports complex, that will take a little while to design. So do you want to wait and actually have a ceremony once we can determine how long it would take to make a sign and the cost, and then have a ceremony at that time and include his family?
I think that'd be great.
Isn't that something that's going to take enough time to budget for the next year? Is it that much of a time lapse?
I wouldn't think so. I'll have to do some research and see exactly what we need to do. We may need to design a new sign and bring it back to the board for approval and get a cost estimate on that.
Mm-hmm.
So we could just start the process today if you're in favor of that, and then bring it back to the board as we go through the different phases.
I think that'd be approved.
Okay. Do we need a vote on that? Stop.
I'm going to make a motion to get the proposals and costs for naming the sports complex after Mr. Adams.
I second.
Motion, all in favor?
Aye.
That's good.
Thank you.
request to waive the boat ramp fees for the Hooked on Heroes. I take a veteran fishing event to be held Saturday, April 10th, 2021, as agended by Commissioner Newman.
So, this is pretty straightforward as far as the activities that are going on there on our service, these veterans and the volunteers go down and help out with that, that use their boats to, accommodate and get back to these Hooked on Heroes. And, so, as you can see in the request, this is a nonprofit group, you know, that's serving veterans of all branches. So, it's a real good opportunity to get back and recognize these folks who have sacrificed so much.
We have done this in the past too.
I've done that in the past.
For several years. Gary, Matheny May used to make signs to go on people's vehicles. Is that something that you have handy? I'm not even sure what they look like. I think they were like placards that people could put in their cars.
Just showing that they're fishing, not Hooked on Heroes. Instead of having the sticker or having the hanger on their mirror, it would be a waiver saying that they were a part of this event and that they were, we certainly wouldn't want to find those folks that are helping our veterans.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't seen one of those, but I mean, we need to make something. So you're going to want the people who are participating to have one and the people who aren't are going to pay?
Yes. So the waiver would only be for those participating in this Hooked on Heroes event. And as I understand it, there should be around 20 somewhere in that neighborhood. I believe previously it was these kind of documents or papers were given to the sheriff's office that then could make sure they're distributed to the folks that are participating in the event.
Okay, yeah, I mean,
I think we can figure something out.
We can help something.
All right.
I make a motion to approve it.
Have a second?
Right.
Motion second, all in favor?
Aye.
Right. 18. 19, board to county administrator.
During the process of reorganizing some of our committees that have been inactive during COVID, I realized that Tasha Tolles, who has been a member of TCRAB since 2015, had not been reappointed to the board. So this is really a housekeeping item for asking the board to reappoint her to the Taylor County Recreation Advisory Board.
Tasha Tolles?
Tasha
Tolles.
Okay.
Motion to approve?
Okay.
Second? All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right, we go to 20. Board to consider the sale of county-owned lots in Keaton Beach as agended by county administrator.
The board has discussed numerous times whether or not you wish to sell some of the county-owned lots down in Keaton Beach. Now, upon review of the maps and trying to ascertain exactly what's where, it would appear that there are pieces of three different lots that are owned by the county. And lots, if you look at your map, lot number three would be the buildable lot. Lot number two is basically primarily county road and right of way. And then lot number one is a small lot that would not be considered buildable because of the setback. So if the board wishes to move forward with the sale of these lots, Conrad, you may have to help me out on this. I believe we'll need surveys of the lots so we can obtain a legal description.
I think that you'd want to do that so whoever purchased each one would know exactly what they're getting by meets and bounds.
Yes,
it may cost a little bit, but that would be good.
I believe we have a legal description on lot number, part of lot number one that includes part of lot number two, because I believe that was a piece of property that the board obtained in a property swap. So we may actually have a legal description for that particular piece of property.
You have to look and check. I think you're probably right. The other thing that you need to realize too, if, you know, if you sell a, an unbuildable lot, you need to, that needs to be part of the disclosure.
Yes, sir.
Because so many folks don't do their vetting to determine, and then they'd be really upset if they bought some, well, I can't do anything with it, you know? So I think that's real important that say, for instance, if we end up with an auction, you've got to let them know.
Yes.
Of course, the unbuildable, you may not even want to sell that because what are you going to do with it, you know?
Right.
Y'all understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, the part, I don't know if you've ever looked at that lot number one there. It's really a part of the folks that live there now. It's really a part of their yard. You wouldn't even know it's not their yard when you go by there today. I mean, they upkeep the property, mow the grass. I mean, I understand you got to do a bid, got to go through a bid process, but you know, these folks would be interested in that. I don't know them, but I know there's some folks that do know them. They would be interested in that lot before allowing someone else to come in and just buy it.
Can you do that?
Offer it to the adjoining property owner first?
Well, no, you weren't saying that.
I wasn't saying that. You got to go through the process, but I mean, I think we need to make sure these folks know.
Well, I understand.
Yes,
okay.
Yeah.
The date of the bid, when the bid process is going on. And if they just got the bid at that point.
So, Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
This proposal would be that the county would pay to have the survey done, does that come with a title search and such to make sure that these parcels are clear, ready to go?
Yes.
And all of these costs would be figured in as the beginning bid?
Yeah, right. What you can do with bid is you can say the minimum bid that the board is going to accept is such and such. So you get your cost if you're doing it right up front. That's a good point, Commissioner Newman.
Yeah, start the bid. And then
right.
Starts at $50,000, and that starts at 50, and one person.
Well, I'm just saying, so the survey, I don't believe, would be an unbudgeted expense.
Exactly.
But we would let that accompany the cost of the lot in the beginning bid would be to include the survey expenses as well as the title search and whatever admin fees that would come along with that. So the next question, I guess, would be in respect to that, once we get those legal descriptions, then would we have an assessed value? I know there's likely one link with that currently, but then when you have this legal description, that will give us a square footage by legal description.
Well, presupposing that it doesn't reach a statutory amount where you'd have to have an appraisal, and I think it wouldn't. You wouldn't have to have an appraisal on their 125-35. So, but y'all, as the board, after y'all can set again, you know, what your minimum bid is. And if you don't get that, then you don't sell it, you know. The other question is, and if I can add to that, is do you want to sell them separately or do you want to just sell it all at once?
I'd rather sell them separately. That would give a neighbor over there that their yard would buy that one.
And then number two there, what is there anything to sell there other than a right of way?
We wouldn't want to sell.
30 by 64 or 30. Yeah,
there's part of number two that would be included with the number one lot, I would say. But the majority of number two is road and right of way.
Are you gonna close it?
If people next door to number one didn't want that, that would make a real nice lot for somebody to have a pleasant lot and just go park there and keep their boat in the water there. You know, I mean, that would be a good place for somebody to just have a place to park,
yeah,
have a pleasant lot in the boat tied to.
Either way, it all goes back on the tax roll.
Mr. Conrad, is this something that you would handle on our behalf, or does staff need to move forward and
get quotes for surveys.
Staff needs to go ahead and get quotes for the survey on that. Bring it back to the board, determine that y'all want to upfront that money. I don't think it's going to be a whole lot, though, to survey it. And once you get the survey, and like Commissioner Newman said, you might want to go ahead and do a title search on it to make sure that, you know, that we do own it. We don't want something we don't know.
And you wouldn't want to pass it along to something.
And then, and then the last step is to determine, you know, to advertise. And I like oral auctions. It's fun, you know. I like to do that. It's just fun. You know, you can do you know, silent bids, but I like to do the oral ones because, number one, you might get a couple of people that are, you know, that get rolling on it. You might make more money that way.
One other question, if I could.
Go ahead.
In relation to getting this description, would we then, or could staff get comparisons as to what the expected would be in the market? So we could have an accurate measure to set not just our costs, but what our reasonable expectation would be for a beginning bid.
I think we could reach out to the property appraiser's office to help us with that, because when you look at the map, the parcels, it's all the same price. So we could reach out to the property appraiser.
But I'm actually looking more so at what the market price is. Yeah, the assessment would be an across-the-board estimation, but when we look at what the market's been doing, and I don't think that's a secret, those are going to be quite a bit different.
Well, in response to that, if I may, you know, my suggestion would be determine, you know, what it's going to cost to do this survey, then what it's going to cost to do the title search. In other words, don't do it until you know how much it's going to cost, and then you can determine whether it'd be worth it to do, you know, to get an appraisal on it. You know, if you end up spending some money that way, I don't think any of it's going to be such that it's going to be prohibitive, but I think as a practical matter, it's a good idea to get all those costs that it's going to be before you jump in.
So, Mr. Chairman, if there's no other discussion, if I could offer a motion to direct staff to get this surveyed and gather the other costs, or I should say a proposal for the survey.
I'll second that.
Okay, then motion second. All in favor? Aye. Aye. Okay.
Just to be clear, that's a motion for the survey and the title search, just to get the proposals for it?
Yes, sir, I think that's what the last was to get cost, and then we can come back and make sure it's not going to be just any other use that came up for these parcels. So we'll get the cost.
Okay. 21, the county administrator discussed information matters.
Just as a reminder, we have a scheduled board workshop on the 23rd. I am still trying to finalize arrangements with Big Bend Homeless Coalition to come and give us a presentation for the city and the county that would start at 5 o'clock. I have not been able to finalize those arrangements as of yet, so I will reach out to each one of you and let you know when you're able to get that done.
Big Bend Homeless Corporation.
Big Bend Homeless Coalition, yes.
Coalition. Okay.
I also wanted to give you a traffic report update from Friday, March the 12th for the Taylor County CARES traffic. There were 8 applications received for individual assistance, 5 applications received for small business assistance, 20 phone calls, 10 emails, and 40 people walked in. So they are keeping up with the stats for us so we know how effective, you know, the advertising was and all the outreach that we're attempting to do to these funds. So I'll keep you up to date on that.
And Big Bend CARES?
That's Taylor County CARES. So that's our round two of our repairs funding.
Walk into this chamber?
Yes, sir. And we do have applications at this office, the library, the grants office, and the chamber. And I think that's been very effective, and has really encouraged people to pick up applications, that we've made them more accessible. Also, just wanted to give you an update on the American Rescue Plan Act of 2021. This was signed into law on March 11th, 2021. There will be a fiscal impact for Taylor County. It looks like that we will receive in excess of $4.1 million.
$4.1?
Million, yes. We're still waiting for some more information from Treasury as far as what we can spend the money on. It's not clear right now. But as of my last update, there are three broad uses of the funds under the Act. Number one is to respond to the public health emergency with respect to COVID-19 or its negative economic impact, including assistance to households, small businesses, and nonprofits, or aid to impacted industries such as tourism, travel, and hospitality. Number two is for the provision of government services to the extent of the reduction in revenue of such metropolitan city, non-entitlement unit of local government or county due to such emergency, or number three, to make necessary investments in water, sewer, or broadband infrastructure. And the time period for this is beginning March 3rd, 2021, and ending on the last day of the fiscal year for the local government, which would be 2024. So we are waiting for some more guidance on this and are not sure at this point if this will be administered directly by Treasury or if it will go through DEM or exactly what will happen, but I will keep everyone updated on that. And then we'll bring a recommendation to the board. There are several consultants have already reached out and offered to help us with the plan to spend these funds. But once we see the Treasury guidelines, we'll know if that's something that we need or not. Okay, thank you.
Okay, we'll go to, is anyone from the public? Is anyone from the public want to speak to?
Yes, sir.
Please, Commissioner.
Yes, sir. Keep up the good work. Enjoy spring break.
Damon.
I might say we fixing to have some skis in Taylor County.
All right.
And we need to, if anybody calls about it, you know, tell them to call in the number to get some skis trucks to come down the road and what have you this time of year. It always, you know, there's a lot of calls. And that people get aggravated because they can't get through, but they just keep calling or leave a message. Maybe they'll get it done. And tell your constituents that they have the dumps that they can throw in the water holes around their house to kill the mosquitoes. Out at on 98 at the office, Gary Wombo's office out there. They'll pass out the dumps and some powder stuff you can put in, like in a drum of water in the yard or something, dump it and kill all the mosquitoes. People every year, you know, do get a lot of that stuff from there, and it helps. It helps to pull along with the spraying. You know, it's that time of the year. That's basically all I got.
Okay. Here.
No.
Bishop.
Yes, sir.
The one that you gave us on your spill. Yes. Do I get a motion?
Motion.
Motion. Motion second. All in favor?
All
right. Yes. I did look at last night traveling.
Yeah.
Dog jumps, you need that. Jumps like the calls and secretary.
Yeah,
If I was out there on 14, going to Madison last night about 1 o'clock.
Yeah.
That thing looked like daylight. And I talked to them one time, they said they didn't have problems too. And we had a bunch of lights out there, it was lemonade.
There you, I know there used to be. But I believe some people, they shoot lights up.
Okay.